for the purpose, really.
That purpose to help address the need for affordable housing. And these volunteers are making that happen all while pedaling across the country. More than 30 young adults from across the country spent the day working in Glidden.
They did. They're helping Habitat for Humanity and the Amy family build a new home. News Channel 8's Angie Hunt was there, but now she's in the Ames Live Link. Angie.
Well, Steve, the Amy family lost their home and their daughter, Trish, in a fire back in January. The entire community is now helping them rebuild, but today they got some added help from a group of Bike and Build volunteers. Pouring concrete for a garage floor is a new experience for many of these volunteers.
Give them a grunt, Ariella!
But with their help, the Amy family gets another step closer to moving into their new home.
And the blessings that you see that come from everybody's hands.
Hands that help pound nails to hang siding and build the family a new shed. Many of these volunteers are college students who are pedaling across the country and putting their various levels of construction skills to work to help provide families with affordable housing.
Just such a big issue in our country and something that really needs to be addressed, and there's no better way to do something for it than to do something about it.
There's a lot of work left to do before the Amy family can move in, but it's impressive for the family to see the enthusiasm and the volunteers' willingness to help.
This morning I pulled up and they were just getting off, and I had goosebumps just to see how energetic they were, ready to go.
It's amazing what we can do with just a few hammers and nails.
I'm gonna nail this corner.
The Bike and Build volunteers will spend the day working on the home before getting back on their bikes and pedaling to their next stop. In 2 months, they'll work on 8 different homes across the country.
It's one thing to ride your bike across country, but it's another to ride your bike across country and help build houses and address the affordable housing crisis.
Just having the chance to eat, talk, and interact with many of the bikers is very special for the Amy family. Cheryl says she can see a lot of her daughter, Trish, and many of the volunteers.
She had that big heart where if you had a problem, she was there. If you needed help to do something, she was there. She wasn't scared to try anything.
And the bikers will pedal to Sioux City tomorrow. The Bike and Build volunteers hope to reach their final destination, Seattle, Washington, by August 17th. If you would like to follow their progress, we have created a link on our website at kcci.com. Now, as for the Amy family and the Habitat for Humanity volunteers, they are hoping the weather will continue to cooperate with them so they can hopefully get the house finished by early September.
Yeah, let's hope so. Thank you.